4-year-old girl dies after accidentally pouring hot water on herself in Indore. Ritika died on the third day of her treatment. Her father, Rampal Golkar, is a watchman by profession. Banganga police said that the incident took place on Wednesday, January 8, in the Karol Bagh area. After post-mortem, the police handed over Ritika's body to the family members. A 4-year-old girl named Ritika died on Friday due to severe burn by accidentally pouring hot water on herself while she was going to take bath. Ritika's mother Pinky had poured hot water on a tub and went to bring cold water to normalize it. In the meantime, the 4-year-old innocent reached the bathroom and poured a mug full of hot water on herself, which led to grievous burns in half of her body. After knowing of the incident, Pinky immediately sought neighbors' help and admitted Ritika to MYH hospital in Indore. Ritika died on the third day of her treatment. Her father, Rampal Golkar, is a watchman by profession and also does workmanship. Rampal and Pinky also have a 2.5-year-old son, Ankit, who was playing outside the house when the incident took place. Originally, Rampal is the resident of Khargone district in Indore. Banganga police said that the incident took place on Wednesday, January 8, in the Karol Bagh area. After post-mortem, the police handed over Ritika's body to the family members. Explaining the incident in detail, the police informed that Ritika was playing inside the house when her mother called her to take bath. Ritika went to the bathroom and, not finding her mother there, poured hot water on herself and screamed loudly. Hearing her voice, Pinky rushed inside the bathroom and found her skin burnt and immediately took measures. However, the police have registered her and is further investigating the matter. Chinese woman travels to Madhya Pradesh's Mandsaur, marries her long-term boyfriend as per Indian rituals in a tale of love transcending two countries. A Chinese woman traveled all the way to India to marry her partner as per Indian customs and rituals. The woman arrived in Mandsaur, Madhya Pradesh, along with her parents and got married to a young man. This story found its roots in Canada 5 years ago, where the duo, Siddharth and Jihao, met in Sheridan College in Oakville. Soon they fell in love and consequently a decision was taken by their families to solemnize the marriage. Shibo Wang and his wife Jingguan from China's Jiang married their daughter to the son of Ved Mishra and Jyoti Nawal and were very pleased with Indian hospitality and customs. They are confident about her daughter's happy married life. The father of the bride called India a great country, adding that he is very impressed by the hospitality and expressed his happiness in marrying his daughter to Siddharth. Jingguan said that her daughter and Siddharth have a very good understanding and is confident of her daughter's happiness. Jihao explained how she came close to Siddharth due to his helpful nature. She added that although Indian wedding customs are different from the traditional way of China, she likes it. Siddharth is also very happy with this marriage. His father said that he got to know about this love by monitoring his son's activities on Facebook. He arrived in Canada to meet his now daughter-in-law in Canada and spoke to her parents in China via video calling. After this, they decided on the marriage. Leave India yourself or get thrown out in MNS style, posters threatening Bangladeshi infiltrators put up in Mumbai's Panvel days after Maharashtra Navnirman Sena MNS Chief Raj Thackeray announced its support to the Narendra Modi-led government in the centre over the eviction of illegal Bangladeshi and Pakistani infiltrators. Several MNS posters, asking the Bangladeshi intruders to leave India, surfaced in Mumbai Panvel area on Tuesday, February 4. The posters come ahead of MNS proposed massive rally against illegal intruders on February 9. Reading, Bangladeshis leave the country lest you will be driven out in MNS style. The posters carry pictures of MNS Chief Raj Thackeray and his son Amit Thackeray, who was recently inducted into the party. Earlier on January 24, Raj Thackeray has said that the party will take out a huge rally on February 9 in Mumbai to drive illegal infiltrators from Pakistan and Bangladesh out of India. Thackeray addressed a public meeting during Maha Adhivation in Mumbai where he said, "We will take out a huge rally on February 9 to drive illegal infiltrators from Pakistan and Bangladesh out of India. There can be a debate on the Citizenship Amendment Act, CAA, but why should we shelter someone who has come from outside illegally?" In December last year, Raj Thackeray had said that the illegal immigrants from Pakistan and Bangladesh should be thrown out of the country irrespective of their religion. He had said that the Citizenship Amendment Act is uncalled for as it will increase the burden on India, which is allegedly not able to cater to the needs of its own people. India is not Dharamshala. People coming from Bangladesh and Pakistan should be thrown out. India had not taken the contract of humanity, Raj Thackeray had said while addressing a press conference in Pune. Raj Thackeray-led MNS recently launched its new saffron-colored party flag that also features Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj's Raj Mudra, Royal Seal. As per the reports, there has been speculation that the BJP will support Raj Thackeray in rebranding his party after the Uddhav Thackeray-led Shiv Sena joined hands with the Congress and NCP to form a government in Maharashtra. 10 killed, 7 injured as dumper collides with SUV in Maharashtra's Jalgaon. 10 people were killed and 7 others injured after a dumper truck collided with their sports utility vehicle SUV in Maharashtra's Jalgaon district, a police official said on Monday. The mishap took place around 11 p.m. on Sunday when Balu Narayan Chowdhury and his family members were on their way to Chinchol village after attending a marriage function in Chopra village, located around 400 kilometers from here, he said. A dumper truck coming from the opposite direction collided with the SUV on Chopra Faspur Road near Hingola village in Yawal Tehsil, the official at Faspur police station said. Chowdhury, his wife and 8 other SUV occupants died on the spot, he said. 7 others in the car sustained injuries and they were taken to different hospitals in Jalgaon, he said. The victims were residents of Chinchol and Mehul villages under Mukti Tehsil, the official added. Oscars 2020, what's inside the 1 crore rupees swag bag that this year's nominees will receive Oscars 2020 are just around the corner, which means that the biggest names will be arriving on the red carpet, dressed up in their glitzy and glamorous ensembles outside the Dolby Theatre in Los Angeles. The coveted golden statue will go home with only 4 actors and 1 director in the top individual categories, however all the other 24 nominees will still get to take home an Oscar swag bag. What's so special about it? Well, the goodie bag contains the most extravagant gifts to begin with and is valued at an extravagant amount. Though each year 25 people receive the swag bag, this year the number is 24 because Johansson is nominated in both leading and supporting actress categories, for Marriage Story and Jojo Rabbit. Created by Distinctive Assets, a celebrity and product placement marketing company, this year's swag bag is valued at US$225,000, which is 1 rupee, 60, 35,075. According to Forbes, the value of all the 24 bags is US$5.4 million, 38 rupees, 48, 74,200. To compare, the cost of making the 24-carat gold-plated statuette is US$400, 28,511 rupees. Reportedly, this year's Oscar swag bag contains a 12-day cruise package, a custom stained glass portrait, a super expensive gold vape pen, a moon bracelet, made from gold and silver spheres, a wellness retreat in Malibu, a package of 10 personal training sessions with LA trainer Alexis Seletsky, handmade luxury eyelashes from Celine Victor, 2 tickets to the Daybreaker morning yoga and dance movement that takes place in 28 global cities, among others. This year's nominees in the top categories include celebrities like Scarlett Johansson, Leonardo DiCaprio, Margot Robbie, Brad Pitt, Renee Zellweger, Adam Driver and Joaquin Phoenix, to name a few. Canada man lies about having coronavirus for viral video, forces plane to make emergency landing. James Potok, a 28-year-old man, created panic on a Toronto to Jamaica flight after he made a false claim that he had coronavirus. The flight had to return and make an emergency landing because of his lie. The man, on board a WestJet flight, stood up from his seat and announced that he had recently returned from the epicenter of coronavirus Wuhan and was feeling really sick. This created panic among co-passengers and the crew decided to return the flight to Toronto as a safety measure. However, when the man was assessed by medical staff upon arrival at the airport, he was deemed to be symptom-free. He later confessed that he played this prank to get viral on social media. "Well, I had my camera with me. I was looking to get a viral video. I was looking to get it up on all the social media platforms," he told Global Times. James Potok took to YouTube to post an apology video. In the 5-minute video, he insisted that he just said that he was feeling sick and did not mention the term coronavirus. However, he did mention his intent to make a viral video. Netizens were rather furious with his insensitive prank. They took to comments section to express their anger. "You realize that people died from the coronavirus, right? I bet you are doing this to get even more views. I hope you grow up," a comment on the video read. "Dude, I get it, everyone who wants to be famous is looking for any little attention. That was the worst way of you to find attention. A little too desperate much," read another comment. Meanwhile, Peel Regional Police Airport Division Criminal Investigation Bureau have charged Potok with mischief and breach of recognizance. He will appear at the Ontario Court of Justice in Brampton on March 9, 2020. Now you can unlock, lock and start your car using Apple iPhone. Apple rolled out the first beta of iOS 13.4 with a set of new features for its users. The iOS 13.4 reportedly has features such as the iCloud folder sharing, new Memoji stickers and a modified mail toolbar. However, the feature that is making the right kind of noise is the one that would turn an Apple iPhone into a car key. As per reports published by 9to5m, the iOS 13.4 apparently has a feature called Car Key which will allow users to unlock, lock and start their car and turn it off. However, that would only work with vehicles compatible with NFC. Sounds interesting, but how will it work? The feature will work with any car that has field communication. You will have to pair your device with the car, and using your wallet app in the iPhone or Apple Watch, you can lock, unlock and turn on your car and turn it off. You also have the option of sharing your digital car key through the wallet app with a friend or a relative who can be trusted. To set up the car key feature, place your iPhone or the Apple Watch on top of the NFC reader in your vehicle. The pairing might take several minutes initially, so do not remove the iPhone from the NFC reader. If the pairing process fails, you can add the car key to the wallet app using a PIN code. It is being predicted that Apple will roll out car key in the next few months considering it is packed with iOS 13.4. However, the car key feature is not something that is being introduced in Apple. For instance, carmaker Hyundai already has a digital key app for Android users only, and it only works with specific models that are compatible with NFC. As interesting as this new car key feature might sound, one cannot overlook the security threats that this feature will bring along. For example, if someone steals your iPhone, locates your car and manages to activate your wallet app, there are chances that the car will start and you will probably lose it. So you must pay utmost attention to the security of your car. You should have your carmaker's app installed on your device that would enable you to use the car key function. So if anyone tries to access your car from their phone, they clearly won't be able to do so. Be very sure about who you share your digital car key with. A car is an expensive thing and you clearly wouldn't like it to get misused. For now, you can only wait for Apple to roll out the car key feature. It would be interesting to see which car manufacturers will sign up for it and which cars it will work for. Only then you will be able to understand whether you really needed this feature or not.